simplicity. Simplicity is greatness and goodness. Simplicity is a glorious discovery. Simplicity is a fruitful birth of peace. Simplicity is our natural, conscious awareness of reality. The simpler we can become, the sooner we shall reach our destination. A life of simplicity is a life of constant progress. It is in simplicity that we can make the fastest progress, progress that is everlasting. Simplicity is a simple word, but everyone knows how difficult it is to become simple in life. Each time a person becomes simple in his life activities, in his life achievements, and in his life successes, he feels that he has achieved self-discovery. And each time he becomes complex or complicated in his nature, he feels that his self-discovery is a far cry. A simple heart runs fast, faster, fastest towards the goal. Simplicity is the most striking and challenging speed when we run along the road of eternity's fulfilling achievement light. A 4-year-old child. To simplify your life, just think of yourself as a 4-year-old child. Try to imagine the way he thinks of reality. If you have to talk to someone about so-called complicated matter, see how you can simplify it. No matter with whom you are talking, feel that you are a child and that person is also a child. Always try to have a childlike consciousness and to see each and every human being as another child. When a childlike quality comes into your life, everything automatically becomes simple. Happiness means the simplicity of life. Your most precious resources. Simplicity, sincerity, and purity are the most precious resources of your heart. You sleeplessly need them. Therefore, value them and admire their worth. If you feel the necessity right now of having millions of things from life, try to minimize your needs. You will see that while you are in a process of minimizing your needs, your life will automatically become disciplined. When you do not give countless outer things your attention, you will see that truth is looking right at you and giving you the strength to discipline your life. Simplicity is the most valuable treasure in God's creation. Do not count the mangoes. If the friend of yours comes and gives you a most delicious mango, will you immediately eat the mango? Or will you ask him a million questions? Where he got it and how much it cost? And whether it was imported from elsewhere or grown in the United States? In the same way, there are two types of spiritual seekers. One type will just see the reality and immediately try to become the reality. The other type will immediately begin to question the reality, examine the reality, and doubt the reality. Suppose both of these seekers are hungry and you take them into a garden where there are many mangoes and many flowers. The first kind of seeker will say, "All right, since there are many mangoes, I will now be able to eat." But the second type of seeker will say, "I wonder how many mangoes are here?" And he will start counting the mangoes. Then he will want to know which one is the best. So he will start examining all the mangoes to decide which one he will take. While he is wasting his time, the first seeker will take a mango and just eat it, and he will be satisfied. If we start counting all the mangoes, perhaps we will never begin eating. Or after a while, we may get tired and say, who wants to know? But during the time we spend in counting, we lose our spontaneous inner joy. If we use the mind, we will always try to analyze everything and we will never experience the reality. But if we use the heart, we will immediately take the action we want. And at that time, even if we eat only one mango, we will get the delight of eating all the mangoes. because the heart means oneness. Complexity clouds will without fail one day surrender to simplicity's transformation sun. Running the fastest. If you are consciously running towards a goal, then naturally you want to get there sooner than the soonest. If you want to run fast, faster, fastest, then you will have to simplify your outer life, your life of confusion, your life of desire, your life of anxiety and worry. At the same time, you have to intensify your inner life, your life of aspiration, your life of dedication and illumination. God Himself is very simple, and inside His simplicity, we feel our constant oneness. Complexity is in the mind, not in the heart. The heart is all simplicity. We need the heart of a child in order to run the fastest. The child's heart is all simplicity. But when the child develops the mind and lives in the mind, then world confusion enters into him. At that time, fear, doubt, anxiety, jealousy, and many other undivine forces weigh him down. So naturally, he cannot run fast. Suppose you and somebody else are walking or running towards a goal. If the other person is carrying a heavy load on his shoulders, whereas you are not, naturally, he will not be able to run as fast as you can. But who compelled him to carry that heavy load? Nobody. It is his self-chosen ignorance. In your case, wisdom has dawned. That is why you know that fear, doubt, and other negative qualities have to be discarded, or they have to be transformed and illumined so that they can become an added help to you in your race. Two problems ahead. My simplicity has at last solved them. My simplicity has transformed my hesitating mind into a daring mind. My simplicity has transformed my fearing heart into a cheering heart. Love, devotion, surrender. God is extremely simple. It is we who think of Him as someone complicated. God speaks the simplest language, only we do not understand Him. Poor God. He has been talking constantly and tirelessly, but we do not have the time to listen to him. One who has love, devotion, and surrender can be simple. A child is simple. He loves his mother. He does not have to love anybody else. His mother is his whole world. He listens to his mother. He devotes himself to his mother. If his mother asks him to do something, he feels that his mother knows everything better than he does. So he surrenders to his mother's will. A child is so simple that he tries to do everything to please his mother. And in his simplicity, he is reaching his highest goal. If you live in the heart, you will act like a child. The simple way is to follow the path of the heart. The beauty of simplicity. A simple man will have only what he needs, and he will know the difference between what he needs and what he wants. We feel that whatever we want, we desperately need. But before we possess the world, to our wide surprise, we see that the world has already possessed us. We want to possess the world in all its multiplicity. We want multiplicity without unity. We want the flowers, fruits, and leaves of a tree without the trunk. But if we do not start with a trunk, with simplicity, then we can never go to multiplicity. Unity is the source, and multiplicity grows out of unity. Simplicity itself is beauty. If somebody is very simple, because of his simplicity, he is beautiful. And if someone has inner beauty, Because of his inner beauty, he is simple. If somebody is inwardly spiritual, he is like a beautiful and simple child. In the outer life, simplicity is beautiful. In the inner life, simplicity is invincible.